and welcome. My name is Kia, and I have a podcast here on YouTube where I talk about the knitted things that I do. And in my previous podcast, I was talking a little bit about what to do with all the sweaters, and what do we do with the sweaters that we're not completely happy with. And this is a sweater I have actually, I realized that this is going to be a good thing to share with you on the podcast. So I have actually already ripped out the neckline, because this has been a problem sweater from the beginning. And as you can see, it's a little, maybe if I could do something to just lay on my shoulders now. But as you can see, it's also very low in the neck. So what I did rip out the neckline, and I ripped out a couple of rows here of the green, and I have it in my pocket. Here it is. So what I will try to do now is to make the neckline so that it will fit. And I have decided to start, I think, here with the short rows. So I will do short rows from here and try to raise it up in the back here. The problem that I have is that I don't have so much more of the beige. But I do have a lot of Galesk, and it's almost the same. This is all Rowan fine tweed. So I will work with the green, because I had, I was up in my stash looking, and I have quite a lot of green. So I will be doing the short rows in green to raise up the back. And then I will be doing the neckline with the maybe the one that I ripped out, and also use some of this Galesk tweed if I have to. So I will start this, because also what happens is when I knitted this one, I made the sleeves to be like this, but what happened with the previous neckline was that the sleeves, they didn't go down, and the neckline was too big, and nothing in the back. So it was very strange to wear, but it's a beautiful sweater, and I'm really, now when it's spring, I want to wear this colorful, lovely joke. As you can see, it's beautiful, and all the Rowan fine tweed is so fantastic to use together. So this is what I will be doing now, and I will come back to you. But I think that this is a good point somewhere here to start to knit, to raise up the back, do some short rows for the neckline. I will come back to you as soon as I make some progress here. I am using the German short rows for the, when I'm turning. So what you do when you do the German short rows, I am putting the thread on the front side of the needle like this, put in the other needle in that stitch, and just draw it back so that you create these two little from the stitch in under, and then you just keep on knitting to the next marker again. And this is how I knit. This is my knit stitches. I am holding it like this. And the thread is on my left point finger. And then I'm in the stitch, take the thread. I think that this will be very good
raising the neckline. I hope it will do the trick. It is such a beautiful sweater, but the neckline has always been a problem with this sweater. I knitted this sweater before Ravelry, so I don't know what needles I knitted this sweater in, but I did pick out 3.25 millimeter needles. I think that's about the right size, maybe 3.5, but I'm not sure. It feels really good when you bring out a problem sweater like this and you fix it. I hope I fix it. So that it will be, I will wear it again. I have been thinking about ripping out the whole yoke and re-knit it, but if this solves the problem, that's good. It's not so much work, just to do a short row neck. So I'm coming to the next marker here. Here's the next marker, and I decided that the two stitches that are for the first turn that I did, and then I am thinking that maybe three stitches before that turn I will do the next turn. So I'm flipping the work again, putting the thread on the front of the needle and into that stitch with the needle, and just draw the thread behind, and then you can start again. And now I'm purling. As you can see, this is how I'm purling. I'm holding the thread on the same pointy finger and putting the thread on the needle, and from the behind I'm picking them up and just picking up that stitch. Yeah, this is continental purling. So three stitches before the previous wrap, I am doing the next turn. So I will build up the back in that way. Oh, and here's the thread to an end, the one that I ripped out. So I will take from a new skein here, and I think I will work. I will work them double for a couple of stitches, just to secure them, instead of having to weave in the ends. So I did knit three stitches in double, with double thread, and then I can just cut them off later. So here we are again. The marker is here and the previous turn stitch was there. So three stitches before, so two more here. And then I will turn again. holding the yarn in front of the needle and putting in the needle in the stitch, and just holding it back, so you create for the previous stitch in under, you see the two legs here, and then you just knit back. So what you do when you come back to those stitches, you have to end this little one row to close everything up, and then you just knit those two legs together as one stitch, and it won't create a hole. The wrap and turn, I think it's it always, I don't get a nice wrap and turn, so the German short rows are perfect for me. I don't have the right technique, I think, for the wrap and turn. There's always a ugly marker there. Oh, and here's the three stitches where I held the yarn double, so I'm just knitting them together. Here we have the first German short row, and we did the same here, and we count to three stitches, so I have to knit three more here before I turn. And the thread is in front of the sweater. You put in the needles in that the stitch, and you just throw it back, and then you can knit again. So we have now made three turns, and that creates like six rows. That builds six rows in the back. So we are now starting to build up here. In the back of the neck, I think I used a little bit too small needle actually, but it doesn't matter now. I will, it's okay. I think I maybe used 3.5, but it's okay. 3.25, it won't make that much difference, and it's in the up in the neckline, so it takes the work together a little bit as well. We shall try the sweater after this turn. I'm glad I saved all the yarns, because this is quite old. I think it's from 2016 or 17, so it has a couple of years now, and it's too bad that it never fitted me perfectly, but because I love the colors and I love the combinations and everything, but the neckline was a problem problem area. So we're back here, and first we have the first turn, then second turn, and now we are turning again here, three stitches in. Same thing again, the yarn in front, put in the needle in that stitch, and just hold it back so you get the two legs from the stitch under, and then you keep on knitting back. So now I have three turns on each side, so when I reach the other side here, I will try the sweater on, so we can see if we have to do some more short rows. I think we do, because this is only like one centimeter, 2 centimeters maybe. I really think I need more.
So I am now trying it on, and as you can see, it's we're getting there. And I think maybe a couple of more rows, just to build up. Or maybe not. I have to do the ribbing as well. Yeah. We'll see. I have to do some decreasing, I think, before the ribbing. So, one more row of the green and wrap all the turns together. Knit the turns together and then do some decreasing. And then the ribbing. So maybe, yeah, I think I will try that. Closed my wraps on this side, and as you can see, you can hardly tell. It's perfect. Here you can see where I have turned. It's those stitches here. So I ended up making 5 turns to build up the neckline, like this, in the back. But now this row, I think we are just knitting the 2 legs, as you can see them, we are knitting them together to make 1. So it can be a bit tricky to get inside. Yes, and we make 1 stitch there. And you can be a bit thoughtful about just stretching the yarn here, so you don't create a loose stitch. So, we have now closed all the stitches, and I will now count how many stitches I have on the needle, because my experience is around 90 to 100 stitches is a good number for the neckline. It depends a little bit on the needle size, of course, but we'll see how many stitches I have, and I will try to do some decreasing here. And I think I would do the decreases between the markers on the back of the neck. So we will do some counting now. Uh,
I have 136 stitches, and I have 30 stitches in the front between the markers. So I have 106 stitches in the back, and I want to go down to maybe, shall we say, 75 in the back. So I have to take away 25 stitches, something like that. And I will start in the back. I'm decreasing quite heavily here on this row, but my experience is that that's the best way to do it, just to do it quite quickly. So we remove the last marker and we start by doing two together and knit two. Very sure about this, but I'm not sure at all. I'm just hoping and guessing here, and this is how we learn, by trying. And if you're like me, you can't think it in your head, you have to try it, and then you learn by experience. So I'm hoping that this will give me a good fit for the neckline, actually. We'll see, and you learn from looking at me trying. That's good for you. So, now we are around one round. So I will now, I think, change color and needles, go down a little bit more. Maybe I should try it on before, but then it's time to change both needles and the color of yarn. Yeah, it feels much better, and it's no leaning out. So if I do the ribbing now with a smaller needle, I think it should be fine. Maybe it's a bit loose still. Yeah, I can do. Yeah, we'll see. I will change. I will change to the next color and maybe do some more decreasing. I have finished the neckline, and I'm so pleased
As you can see, it really fits me now. And what I did was I decreased, after doing the short rows, I decreased to 90 stitches, from 135 to 90 stitches. And yeah, it really lays nicely around both the neckline and the shoulders now. So I think I have saved this sweater, and I will now start to get much more use out of it. Because I can move, and the neckline doesn't make funny things. It stays like it is. So, a success!